In 2005, China's ICT market was worth $480 billion. The Chinese government has predicted that this is going to rise to $870 billion by 2010, so just a couple of years away. They're encouraging Chinese people to see ICT as an integral part of their lives through the policy of informatization, or informatization, i.e. getting everything online. The major centres of China's ICT sector are in the developed regions and large cities along the east and south coast of China. However, the Chinese government has committed to developing the western regions as well, which lag behind economically. Telecommunications is one of the fastest growing industries in China. The latest statistics show that by the end of July 07, there were more than 880 million telephone users in China. The mobile telecoms industry in China is monopolised by these two companies, China Mobile and China Unicom. And China Mobile, which is by far the larger of the two, claims its network is one of the most advanced 2G and 2.5G networks in the world. China has surpassed the United States now to become the world's largest internet market in terms of number of users. The number of internet users has grown at an average of over 6 million users per month in 2007, and it's now estimated that there are as many as 228.5 million internet users in China, which compares with 217.1 in the United States. Revenues from China's online game sector totaled $1.88 billion in 2007, and Chinese trading revenue generated from business-to-business e-commerce was worth approximately $173 billion in 2006. China's software industry is also growing rapidly. The same with pretty much every industry in China. It's the figures kind of hard to believe because they're so huge. But the operating revenue of the China software industry reached approximately $49 billion in the first three quarters of 2007, which is an increase of 23% compared to the same period in 2006. Chinese digital companies understand the Chinese market very well, and it's their view that the majority of internet and mobile content users in China are low-end users, and they typically like Chinese-style content. Last year, one online game in China allowed players to eradicate corrupt officials, and it proved so popular that its website crashed. It was downloaded more than 100,000 times in the first week of its launch. China is the world's largest TV market. Its cable TV industry generated $4.9 billion revenue in 2007 and is expected to grow at over 7% to be worth $6.9 billion by 2012. China's semiconductor industry experienced strong growth as a result of the continued demand for integrated circuits by the rapidly growing electronics manufacturing industry. In 2006, China's semiconductor industry became a $62 billion market and now accounts for a quarter of the world's total. There are lots of barriers to doing business in the ICT sector in China. It's still a heavily regulated industry. The market is for the most part handled by the Ministry of Industry and Information, which has recently been restructured. However, there are many other departments play a role. For example, the State Administration for Radio, Film and Television and the State Council Informatization Office. According to the experience of one successful British software company in China, most manufacturers will eventually buy a license from them because they don't want to get into trouble with the authorities. But as I've said, monitoring cases of infringement and taking action requires an investment in time and resources. Although quite often a simple cease and desist letter is sufficient. But that's enough about the barriers. To finish off, I'd like to talk to you about a success story. M Cashback is a London-based mobile marketing company who have concentrated significant efforts in mainland China. They provide wireless value-added services that benefit both retailers, mobile telecom operators, and Chinese consumers. M Cashback created their Chinese subsidiary, Sino M Cashback, in late 2006. And since then, they've signed up major provincial and municipal branches of China Mobile, as well as leading supermarkets, white good retailers, and convenience stores. Their concept is simpler. Essentially, you go into your supermarket, you see a product, such as a jar of coffee, which will have their logo on, pop it into your trolley. When you get to the checkout, it's scanned, and you get a number of free minutes. You'll have a number to text on your receipt. You text off to that number with your code, and you get a number of free minutes on your mobile for buying the coffee. And you can also use it to top up your mobile. So instead of taking the change in cash, you can take it as a top up onto your mobile. You also use it to buy content. The system is particularly suited to China because it appeals to people who use prepaid SIM cards, which benefits the operators because if people have more free minutes on their phone, they're more likely to talk longer. Other British ICT companies that have been successful in China include Antenova, ARM, BT. The list is on the screen.